Hi there, Paul Carney Arts here, and in this lesson I'm going to show you how to draw and shade a basic still life. Today I'm going to show you how to draw some fruit. This is a relatively simple exercise, but it's very good for teaching you the basics of how to do observational drawing and then how to shade it. So when I want to begin drawing this arrangement of fruit, I have to think, how do I want to set it out on the paper? Do I want to draw it really big, so it goes right off the edges? Am I going to do it small, in the middle? Am I going to do it over to one side and leave lots of space? Or am I just going to centre it? And for the benefit of this film, I'll just keep it nice and simple. So what I'm going to do first of all is sketch out the basic shapes that make up the fruit. I'm sketching them lightly. And I'll sketch my orange. And then my apple, which is kind of nearly like a circle, but it's just got a thinner part at the top. Like this. And then my pear doesn't touch the side of the apple. It kind of goes off like this. And then it's got that lovely, kind of it rounds off there. Then it's got this lovely shape at the top there. It's going a bit off the paper that, so let's move that down a bit. So I've drawn a circle and then I've added this extra bump on the top. And then over this side I've got my tomatoes, my cherry tomatoes. And I'll just draw them in as simple circles. I'm not trying to be too neat at the moment. I would even do this lighter if it was my own drawing, because I'm pressing a bit too hard to show you my guidelines. There we go, just like that. Okay, so you can see them. Right, okay, I haven't put the banana in. It's kind of going off the page a little bit. I'll just do that across there. Apologies about the lack of a banana. So, to be honest, I'll just mark in where the core of the apple is here at the top and where the top of the orange is. And that's about as much as I really need to do to sketch out. What I'd like to start doing now is to shade it. And to do that, I'm going to use a 2B pencil, which I'm just going to sharpen because that's not sharp enough. Okay, my pencil's now sharp. I'm going to begin with the apple, and the way that I'm going to start shading the apple is to put an even layer of tone over the whole of the shape, like so. Now, I've got to try and make sure there's no gaps, and it's neatly up to the edges. I don't want to be going over the edges of the shapes, okay? Because it's a soft pencil, I can get into those gaps and blend them all in with my finger. Okay, so that's a base layer of tone over the whole of the object, and I do the same thing with the orange, the tomatoes, the pear and the banana. But the issue I've got now is that I can't really see the light and shade on those pieces of fruit properly. And that's because there's lights on in the room. And if you have lights on, it gives you too much light. It doesn't show you where the natural light areas and dark areas of the fruit are. So what you need to do is to switch the lights off. Okay, now what I can see when I'm studying it, now the lights have been turned off, The shadows and highlights stand out much more strongly. Look at the orange. There's a very strong highlight there because the light's shining from the window. And then around the outside edge of the orange, around the back of the orange, it's in shade. The apple has highlights on this top of the oval, but then inside of this oval, where the core is, it's shadow. Around the back of the apple is shadow, and at the front is the highlight. The pear has a highlight at the front and shadows round the back. But it's also got a shadow from the banana, which is in front of the pear, the light shining on it, and it's casting a shadow in the distance behind it. And that's also happening with the tomatoes. Highlights on the front and shadows at the backs of all the objects, and then a cast shadow where it's hitting the orange. If that wasn't difficult enough, we also have shadows on the base, but in the back it's quite light, and that's because it's catching a lot of light from the window. I also want to point out the shadows here, that's on the back of the box, where the apple, the orange and the banana and the pear are all casting shadows. But in between here, in between the apple and the pear, it's quite light. So I've got a lot of information here, and now what I need to do is to start applying that shading information onto my drawing. Okay, so I'm going to start by drawing the apple. And the way that I'll do the apple is, remember there's that ring of light tones just around the top there, and there's a dark core area in the centre. So I'll start by shading the central core in of the apple, and I might just now press hard and put the stalk in there like that. Just shade around there with my detail hand, just to get a very dark edge there. And then round here's highlight, so I'm going to begin shading some darker tones here, just right round the back of the apple, like so. And I'm trying to keep this circular shape there, because that's important. Like so. Just want to darken in a ring all the way around that. Yeah. And I'm not too worried about there being gaps in this. That's because the apple has natural streaks in it. And lines, and I want to try to build them up. So I'm following the contour of the apple. The contour is the outside shape, and when the lines are straight at me, when they're directly in front of me, they're straight almost. And the further I get, they get to the edge, the more curved they are, until you get to the very edge, when they are following the contour of the apple. Yeah, so what you can see there is these lines help to create the illusion that it's round. Yeah, and I'm going to have to build these up. When an object is going further away from you and it's disappearing round an edge, it gets even darker because there's less light on it. So if I put those dark edges in and then gradually blend them, I get the illusion that it's disappearing around the surface. And I'm just going to build some of these lines up quickly. I haven't got a lot of time, and I'm going to do the same thing on the other side, going round the outside edge, dark, detail hand, get it nice and neat on the edges, building those lines up like that. And then I'm just going to turn my paper so I can get around the back of the apple like this, trying to make it natural and that lovely rounded curve at the top. So I'll keep going now, drawing this and shading it in. And I'm just going to shade something underneath. There, a little shadow underneath, because again it's disappearing underneath the surface of the apple. And I'm going to add some more of these lines and textures on. Like that. Keeping going up. The surface of the apple is lighter here, so I don't want to do as much shading or as many lines. Just trying to show you where they would be. So you can see I've been working into my drawing, building up those lines and shapes and textures. And I've rubbed out areas on the surface of the apple and the pear and the orange to make it look shiny. Just need to pick up some more shiny bits on here, and it just helps to create that feeling of the illusion of 3D when you've got the highlights and the shadows. And it's important that the areas that are curving away from you are shaded darker and these areas as a lighter, and then I've got my shadows on the bottom on the surface of the table. And if you can do this shading simple fruit, then you can go on to more complex things.